So far, we have validated Kafka by creating simple topic called test and publishing messages as well as consuming messages from the topic. Now let us take a more realistic example where we'll be generating log messages using our simulator called Genlogs and stream those messages through Kafka. That being said, we'll be creating a Kafka topic and publish as well as consume messages from the topic. Before getting into the details, let us open terminal and make sure Zookeeper and Kafka broker are running. I'm using telnet command. As our Zookeeper is running on localhost 2181, I'm telneting through that. It seems to be down, and hence I will start Zookeeper by using Zookeeper server start.sh daemon opt kafka config zookeeper.properties. Also, we will validate our Kafka broker, which is running on localhost 9092. It is also down. And let me start it, kafka server start.sh daemon opt kafka config server.properties. Now let me run telnet on both 2181 as well as 9092 to make sure that Kafka as well as Zookeeper are running without any issues. Both of them are running. Now it is time for us to create our topic called retail. Let us go through the details. The name will be retail. We will try to create it with three partitions. As we are only using a single Kafka broker, we cannot configure replication factor for more than one because we don't have multiple nodes to have multiple copies of these partitions. Okay, so before actually creating this topic, let us run ls-ldr on tmp kafka logs. This is the location where files related to our topics will be preserved. And if you run this command, as of now, there is nothing here. Earlier, I have created test, but the test is deleted already. That's why you don't see anything here. Now, I'll be creating a new topic using kafka topics.sh. To create topic using Kafka topics, we have to pass Zookeeper information using Zookeeper as control argument and the port number 2181. Create is the control argument to create the topic, and we have to pass the topic name, which is nothing but retail. And here we will be defining partitions to be three and replication factor as one. Now the topic is created. Let us see what happens internally. Here I have three windows because I have defined partitions for retail to be three. There will be three directories which will be created under temp kafka logs, and they are nothing but temp kafka logs and then retail 0, retail 1, and retail 2. Let us run retail hyphen 0 in this screen and then retail 1 and then retail 2. If you look at the output of all these three different commands on three different directories, the file names are same. You can see here there are three files. One is with extension log, second one is with extension index, third one is with extension time index. We need to understand what are the purpose of this all these files, and we will actually get into those details at a later point in time. For now, we'll be primarily focusing on this .log file. You can see all these three directories, retail 0, retail 1, and retail 2, have a file with all zeros .log as the extension, and the size of these files is 0, which means they are empty as of now. We just created the topic and we didn't publish any messages. Now let us actually start publishing the messages. And here we are trying to publish the logs generated by our visitor traffic simulator Genlogs. Let us make sure it is running by running taillogs.sh command. As of now, it is not running. To run, let me run this startlogs.sh command. It's start_logs.sh and then tail_logs.sh. Now you can see that data is being generated. We can actually pipe this logs which are generated into Kafka topic using Kafka console producer, which we have seen already. So here I am running this tail_logs.sh and piping the messages which are being generated into the log file into Kafka console producer.sh. And for this Kafka console producer.sh, we need to pass broker list. And here we have to specify the IP address, which is nothing but localhost, and 9092, which is the default port number on which the broker is running. And then we have to give the topic name, which is nothing but retail, and hit enter. Now you see the output of this tail_logs.sh, which was printing earlier, is piped into this Kafka console producer command. Now if you run ls-ltr command on these three directories, you will see the size of this .log file is consistently changing. Okay, which means the messages are being populated into these three log files because we have created the topic with three partitions. What is the rationale behind partitioning topics and how the data will be populated into these partition topics? We will actually get into those details at a later point in time. That being said, now it's time to validate that we can consume the messages from this topic. For that, you can just use Kafka console consumer.sh and it can connect to the Kafka broker by using bootstrap server. It is a control argument. For this, we need to pass the details about Kafka broker. In our case, it is running on localhost 9092. And then we have to give the topic name, which is nothing but retail, and hit enter. As we did not specify from beginning, it is only reading data going forward. That's why you are able to see only one message at a time. If you want, you can actually define from beginning as part of the control arguments, and you can actually get data from the earliest messages that are available from these log files. Okay, now you see data is being produced into the Kafka topic from tail_logs.sh output, and the files are being updated at regular intervals. You can see here retail 0, retail 1, and retail 2. The file is being updated consistently, and also we are able to see the output using Kafka console consumer. So from this you can understand that, let's say you have modularized your project in such a way that you produce the messages, but you want to validate whether the messages are being produced or not. In that case, you will be writing the producer module using whatever programming language you have decided to use, and then use Kafka console consumer in the backend to make sure that you are able to produce the messages successfully. So like this, these command line commands come handy to validate as well as troubleshoot certain issues with respect to topics that are created using Kafka. Now we'll get into further details with respect to Kafka and try to understand all these different terms as we explore Kafka in detail.